Hello children, myself Anindita Banerjee back again with another informative video for you all. I hope you are watching my videos regularly. Please do watch it because I am explaining the science chapter. Okay, now today I am going to start with the third chapter, the skeleton and the muscular system. I hope you have completed the first two chapters. You have written down the answers in very good handwriting and without any mistakes. Okay, now today I shall start with the third chapter. This chapter is a very interesting chapter, but you have to listen to it very carefully. Okay, so be attentive and watch my video and listen to it carefully. The third chapter is the skeleton and the muscular system. Okay, this is a very interesting chapter, but you have to listen to it very carefully. Okay, as you know, when a house is being made, first the pillars is made with the help of beams. Okay, and this house is based on those pillars. Okay, so the rest of the house, such as ceilings, walls, all of these rest on the pillars. So they form a rigid framework that holds the house together. The house doesn't falls down. Why? Because of the pillars or the beams. Okay, likewise a human body also is made up of framework, which is known as skeleton. Okay, and it has a vertebral column or the backbone. Okay, so the backbone which human beings possesses, it is via vertebrates. Some animals do not have a backbone and they are known as invertebrates. Is it clear? So now we shall start with the skeleton system. First of all, you should know the definition of skeletal system. Okay, now what is skeleton system? The framework of bones. Okay, it is the framework of bones that supports our body and provides rigidity. Okay, now what is rigidity? It is the ability to bend or be forced out of shape. Okay, is called skeletal system or simply skeleton. So I repeat once again, the framework of bones that supports our body and provides rigidity is called the skeletal system or the skeleton. Okay, now this skeleton system has certain functions. Now what are these functions? Okay, it gives shape to a body. It gives shape to a body. You can see the picture of skeleton system on the screen. Okay, so it gives shape to a body. Okay, and it also provides support to a body. Okay, that is why we are able to stand erect. That means straight. That is why we are able to stand straight. Okay, and it also protects the vital, that is most important, internal organs of a body. What are those internal organs? Brain, heart, lungs, spinal cord. So the skeletal system has many important functions. I hope the important functions of skeletal system are clear to you all. Yes. Now see, in the screen it is shown that the skull, it protects the internal organs, stores and releases fats, produces blood cells, stores and releases minerals. The different parts of the skeleton performs different functions. Okay, facilitates movement, supports the body. Okay, now I come to the next page, that is 33. Page 33 is the first page of the skeletal and muscular system. I've completed that. Now I move on to the second page, that is page 34. Now the skeleton of adult human being has 206 bone. You are not an adult now, so you don't have 206 bones, but I am an adult. I have 206 bones. Okay, okay. Now again I repeat, the skeleton system, see, it's on the screen, supports body, protects vital organs. You know what are the vital organs? That is the heart, the lungs, the kidneys. Allows movement. You are able to move forward, you are able to move backward. Okay, it stores minerals, aids red blood cells production. Red blood cells are produced. Okay, and it stores chemical energy. Okay, Now, I come to the skeletal tissues or bones. See, the skeleton system consists of bones. It consists of bones, cartilage, tendons and ligaments. See, okay. Now the functions of skeleton system, once more, it gives support to a body, it protects the internal organs, it helps in movement, it helps to store the minerals and it produces red blood cells. Okay? Clear? Again, see? It is on your screen, the functions of skeletal system once again. It gives shape and support to a body and it protects your internal organs. And major muscles are attached to the bone and help them to move. Okay. Blood cells are formed in the center of many bones in the soft tissues called marrow. Calcium and phosphorus are stored in the skeleton for later use. Calcium and phosphorus make bones hard. These two minerals, they make our bones hard. So which are the two minerals? Calcium and phosphorus. Okay. See, an adult human body has 206 bones. Okay. Now what about newborn baby? A newborn baby has more than 300 bones. Okay. And as the baby grows, some bones they join together. That is why it becomes 206 bones when they are adult. Okay. And the bones are of different shapes and sizes. All bones are not of same shape and size. Okay. They are of different shapes and sizes. Okay, and all of them, they are attached to one another. See, baby have 300 bones, but adult have 206 bones. Now, the question arises, why, how can 300 be converted to 206 when you are an adult? Because a newborn baby has more than 300 bones, and as the baby grows, some bones, they join together. Okay, that is why an adult, when the baby turns to an adult, it has 206 bones. Clear? Again, the functions of skeletal system or the skeleton, it supports body, protects the vital organs. I told you, what are the vital organs? That is heart, lungs, kidneys. It allows movement. We are able to move forward, backward. Okay? It stores minerals in our body, aids red blood cells production and stores chemical energy. I hope it is very much clear. Okay? See, it is on the screen. Let me read it. When you were born, your skeleton had around 350 bones. Okay. By the time you become an adult, you will only have 206 bones. Okay. As you grow, some of the bones join together. That is fuse, join together to form one bone. Clear? Now we come to the next topic in your book, that is the tissues. Okay. Now bones are made up of tissues. Yes. Now, what are these tissues? We define tissue as groups of cells that are similar in structure or function. They are both similar, same in both structure and functions. There are four main types of tissues. You no need to know now. When you'll go to higher classes, you'll be knowing much more about it. Okay. And this chapter will continue in 6, 7, 8 gradually. And those who want to become doctor, please pay attention and listen to what I say, because this chapter is very important. Okay. So there are four main types of tissues. No need to know about it now. Just I'm telling for the extra information. The epithelial tissue, connective tissue, muscle tissue and nervous tissue. Okay. Okay. So bones are made up of tissues. Yes. See, what is tissue? A definition of tissue, a group of connected interdependent cells. They are dependent on each other. That cooperate to perform a specific function. They cooperate with each other to perform a specific function. Clear? So, have you understood what is tissue is? Okay. Now, bones also have nerves and blood vessels. See, nerves. Can you see nerves? These are the nerves present in your body. Okay. So bones have nerves as well as blood vessels. See, picture of nerves. These are the blue colored. It is nerves. Clear? and these are the blood vessels. They carry blood to different parts of the body. Can you see the picture? Blood vessels? Yes. Okay. So bones have nerves as well as blood vessels. Okay. But bones, remember, bones, you know, as everyone knows, that bones are hard outside. They're hard, but they're soft and spongy inside. Bones are hard outside, but they're soft and spongy inside. Okay. Now, what do you mean by spongy? That is especially being porous. It is compressible. That, you know, you have seen sponges or absorb, that it can absorb. Okay. So, bones are hard outside, but they are soft and spongy inside. Okay. And they contain, these bones contain a soft tissue, which is known as bone marrow. This bones contain soft tissue called bone marrow. Okay. Yes, clear? What is the idea of bone marrow? Yes, you have eaten the chicken legs, that the when you eat the leg piece and when you bite that bone, the leg piece, certain red things are there, which is the bone marrow, okay? So they are soft tissues, okay? And new blood cells are produced here only, where? In the bone marrow. Clear? New blood cells are produced here in, okay, only in the bone marrow. Okay, now bones also perform certain functions. Bones also perform certain function. See, bones, the picture on the screen. Bones are hard outside, okay, and soft inside. Yes. No need to go to the details, just see the picture. Bones are hard outside, bone marrow, and they are soft inside. Clear? Okay, now I come to the functions of bones. What are the functions of bones? Bones, along with the muscles, that means with the muscles, they help us to move our body parts. With the help of bones, we are able to move our body parts. Okay, and most of the blood cells are produced inside the bones. I told you, most of the blood cells are produced inside the bones. Okay, and bones also store calcium for the body, you know, which is good for our bones. Calcium, yes. Often the grandparents, they consume tablets of calcium, okay, for their bones. Okay, and milk is also a good source of calcium, which you should have at this stage. Okay, so please have a glass of milk every day. Why? Because it will provide calcium for your bones. Okay. Yes. Now see, bone marrow, two types of bone marrow are there: red bone marrow and yellow bone marrow. Clear? So bone marrow is a spongy tissue that fills the inside of your bones. And there are two types of bone marrow. What are they? Red bone marrow and the yellow bone marrow. What is the function of red bone marrow? It helps to produce blood cells. And yellow bone marrow helps to store fat in your body. So have you understood what is the function of red bone marrow? It helps to produce blood cells. And yellow bone marrow helps to store fat. Clear? Is it clear to you? Yes. See, bone marrow, yellow bone marrow. Again, I repeat, yellow bone marrow helps to store fat. This yellow bone marrow helps to store fat. Clear? And red bone marrow helps to produce blood cells in your body. Clear? I hope it is clear. Bone marrow. Yes. Functions of bones, I'll repeat it once again. It helps to support our body. It gives protection to protect the soft organs. It helps in movement. Okay. It helps in storage of minerals, that is calcium and phosphorus, and it produces blood cells. Clear? Now we come to another topic in your book, that is the skull. And the skull is made up of 22 bones. Okay. Out of this, 8 bones cover and protect the brain. okay? So 8 bones, they cover and protect the brain. 8 bones, they cover and protect the brain. So how much is left? 14. So the remaining 14 makes up the face. Clear? The remaining 14 makes up the face. The remaining 14 makes up the face. Clear? Now, out of 22 bones, only the lower jaw bone is movable. This lower jaw. The lower jaw is movable, okay? And the skull, as you see, it protects the eye, the inner part of the ear, nose and mouth. Clear? So, the skull protects the eyes, the inner part of the ear, nose and mouth. Okay, and the skull also gives a characteristic shape to our face. Because of the skull, we have a proper face. Clear? See? Skull. Okay. The lower jaw is movable. Okay. The upper jaw is not movable. Clear? See? Again, I repeat, the skull, it protects the eye, the inner part of the ear, nose and mouth. Clear? Are you afraid of the skull by seeing the picture? I hope not. Okay, it is just a picture on the screen. So, don't be afraid. Clear? See, now, a male skull is slightly different from a female skull. See, male skull, it is slightly different from a female skull. Clear? Yes. Now we come to another topic of your book, that is backbone. The other name for backbone is spine. This is a picture of a backbone or a spine. Okay. And this backbone is made up of 33 bones called vertebrae. And the singular is vertebra. Okay. Again, I repeat. The other name for backbone is spine. And the backbone is made up of 33 bones. Okay. And it is called vertebrae. Okay. And they form a column called the vertebral column. And it protects the spinal cord. Yes. And this vertebral column, it forms a main axis, the main root of the skeleton. Clear? See? Clear? So again I repeat, backbone, the other name for backbone is spine, and it is made up of 33 bones, which is known as vertebrae, and the singular bone is vertebra. And they form a column called the vertebral column, which protects the spinal cord. Okay? See? Can you see the picture on the screen? Yes. See again picture of the spinal cord. Okay. Clear? Now, the joints between two vertebrae, have an intervertebral disc. Can you see? This is the intervertebral disc. That is, the joints between two vertebrae have an intervertebral disc. An individual vertebra cannot move. That means a single vertebra cannot move. Okay. But the spine has some flexibility. That means the spine can move a little bit. Okay. That is why we are able to bend our back. Yes. If our spine would be fixed, we would not be able to bend our back. Clear? So, yes. And you know, exercise and good posture help to maintain the flexibility of the backbone. That means if we do proper exercise, proper exercise, okay, and we maintain a good posture, it will improve our backbone. Clear? See, exercise is being done by a lady. Yes. Why? To maintain the flexibility, that is the movement of the backbone. Okay. Otherwise it will become stiff. Otherwise the backbone will become stiff. That will, it will not be able to move swiftly or properly. Okay. See. Now good posture. What do you mean by good posture? Proper posture. Okay. See. Okay. These are the different pictures of posture. That is nothing but position of body. Proper position of body. Your posture should be proper. Otherwise you will have back pain and all that. Okay. See, bad posture, good posture. Can you identify how the person is bent? And this is straight. So this is good posture. This side is bad posture. Yes. Clear? Okay. See, different exercises is being done. Okay. I hope you do exercises at home. Now, as you don't have to come to school, please do exercises at home to maintain the flexibility of your backbone. Okay. Okay. Now we come to the next topic of your book, that is rib cage. This is a picture of a rib cage. Okay. And the rib cage is made up of 12 pairs of bow shaped bones. See, 12 pairs of bow shaped bones. Okay. Rib cage. See structure of the rib cage. Yes. Again, the picture of rib cage. Yes. And it is made up of 12 pairs of bow-shaped bones. And what is the function of the rib cage? It protects the heart and the lungs. It protects the heart and the lungs. Clear? See, it is protecting the heart and the lungs. So, what is the function of the rib cage? It protects the heart and the lungs. Now, the first rib. See, the first rib. Can you see the first rib? The first rib, can you see, is the shortest and most curved, and it is most curved. Okay, clear? And the rib cage has another long bone in the front, that is the sternum. Can you see the picture? See, sternum. This is the sternum. Clear? It is the sternum. Okay. So the rib cage has another long bone. See, it is long and it is known as sternum, or it is, the other name is breastbone, or it is breastbone. Okay. The other name for sternum is breastbone. Okay. And the ribs are attached to the sternum in the front and to the backbone at the back. Okay. So ribs are attached to the sternum in the front and at the back to the backbone. Okay. And the last two pairs of ribs are not attached to the backbone. They are not attached. Okay. Therefore, that is why these two ribs are known as floating ribs. Can you see? Floating ribs. They are not attached to the backbone. Therefore, they are known as floating ribs. So, the last two pairs of ribs are not attached to the backbone. That is why they are known as floating ribs. Clear? Yes. Okay. Now we move to the next part, that is the limbs. I had discussed this earlier in my earlier videos. Okay. Now we human beings have two pairs of limbs in our body. Yes. Four limbs or front limbs, I told you. Front, four for front. That is the arms. This is the arms, okay? And the hind limbs or the legs. Hind limbs or the legs, yes? And this, our arms and legs are made up of many bones. They don't have only one bones. And the upper The upper arm is made up of one bone, that is the humerus. See, upper arm is made up of one bone and it is called humerus. Okay. And the lower arm has two bones, that is the radius and ulna. Clear? That is, the upper arm is made up of one bone, that is the humerus. Okay. And the lower arm has two bones. What are they? That is the ulna and the radius. Clear? Is it clear to you? See, it is the picture of the four limbs, that is the arm. Okay, again I repeat, the upper arm is made up of one bone called humerus and the lower arm has two bones, that is the ulna and radius. Clear? See, this picture also I had shown you before. Okay, red lines represent the four limbs, that is the arms. Okay. And while the blue lines represent the lower limbs or legs. Yes. Clear? Now, the thigh or upper part of the leg has long bone, that is called femur. This is the femur. Femur, okay. The thigh or upper part of the leg has one long bone called femur, okay. And it is the longest bone in the body. So, if the question comes, which is the longest bone in the body, you will tell femur. It is femur. And it bears the whole weight of the body, okay. Femur. Our body bears the whole weight on this femur. Clear? Now, again, this is the femur. And this part, the part below the knee, it is made up of again two bones, that is tibia and fibula. Clear? Yes. As the upper part of the arm had two bones, the lower part of the arm has two bones, that is radius and ulna, and the part below the knee has two parts, that is fibula and tibia. Clear? So I think this part is clear to you. Now I'll move on to the next topic. That is girdles. See, femur. It is the longest bone in the body and it bears the whole weight of the body. Okay. And the lower part of the leg, that is below the knee, it has two parts, that is fibula and tibia. Yes. Now I'll move on to girdles. Yes. Girdles. Yes. Now what are these girdles? What are these girdles? The girdles are a set of bones that form a semicircular structure. It is like a semicircle structure to which other bones are joined. Yes. Again, I repeat myself that girdles are a set of bones that form a semicircular structure to which other bones are joined. Okay. Okay. And there are two pairs of girdles in human body. One is pectoral girdle, or the shoulder girdles that forms the shoulder, and the other is the pelvic girdle that forms the hip. Clear? Clear? Pectoral girdle that forms the shoulder and the pelvic girdle that forms the hip. See, this is the picture of the pectoral girdle that forms the shoulder. Clear? Now, the pelvic girdle, I told you, it forms the hip. It forms the hip. No need to go in so much details. You just should know that it has the girdles. There are two types of girdle: one pectoral girdle, which forms the shoulder, and the other is pelvic girdles that forms the hip. This much bus. Okay. Yes. And the humerus bone, which I shown you, it is attached to the pectoral girdle, and the femur bone to the pelvic girdle. Okay. The pelvic girdle also supports the upper body. The pelvic girdle also supports the upper part of the body. Okay. Clear. See, humerus. Humerus is what I told you. The humerus bone is attached to the pectoral girdle and forms the femur bone to the pelvic girdle. Clear? Yes. Now I move on to the next topic of your book, that is the what? Joints. Yes. The movable joints. Bones are held together at the joint by a strong fibrous tissue called ligaments. These are usually attached above and below the joint. Can you see the ligament on the knee? The picture is given. Yes. Now, how are bones held together? The thick connective tissue that attaches muscle to the bone. So, the thick connective tissue that attaches muscles to the bone are called tendons. Clear? Yes. Now, see what is a picture on the screen? A boy kicking a football. Yes. With the knee, okay, in a specific direction. See? Whereas a girl playing badminton with the arms has different movement. Yes. Okay. So can we move our back in similar manner of this way? No. So some parts of a body can move while others cannot. And this movement can be bending, twisting, lifting. Okay. See? Joints. Okay. So what are joints? Our ability. The ability to bend our arms and legs. Okay. And it makes us easy to, makes easy for us to do different things. We are able to do this because of the joints present in our body. Okay. Because of the presence of joint, we are able to bend our knees. Okay. See. Have you understood? So two bones are joined together at joints. And the bones bend at the joint. Okay. Our body has many joints. Okay. And all the joints except those in the skull can move. Which joints are present in the skull? They only cannot move. The rest joint which are present in a body can move. So the joint which is present in the skull which cannot move, they are immovable joints. Okay. So the joints which are present in the skull which cannot move are immovable joints. And the joints present in the body, the rest part of the body which can move, are known as movable joints. Clear? So thanks for watching, and please don't forget to subscribe for more, because when only I'll upload any video, you'll get the notification of it. Okay. And please, if you cannot understand anything, please write in the comment section. I'll try to clear your doubts. Okay. Thank you for watching my video once again. Please, I'll upload this chapter in the website. Please, those who have not taken the books yet, please go through the chapter, read it, okay? And I'll go to the next topic on my next video. Thank you, children. Please stay at home. Please do your studies seriously.